Mr. Farage, on behalf of non-attached members.
Well, I may be speaking from the back of the chamber today, but as I predicted last time I was here, in the European elections, the Brexit Party were very much to the front of the elections and massive, massive winners. And I come back to a place that has been humbled and humiliated. The European Council stitch-up has rendered this place impotent until today, when you've got some real power if you choose to use it. What you've seen from Ursula von der Leyen today is an attempt for the European Union to take control of every single aspect of our lives. She wants to build a centralised, undemocratic, updated form of communism that will render nation-state parliaments, where the state controls everything, where nation-state parliaments, where nation-state parliaments will cease to have any relevance at all. I have to say, from our perspective, in some ways, I'm really rather pleased, because you've just made Brexit a lot more popular in the United Kingdom. Thank God we're leaving. Yeah. But it is in the aspects of defence that I think people's minds should be focused. She's a fanatic for building a European army, but she's not alone. When it's completed, NATO will cease to exist or have any relevance in Europe at all. And of course, not to be left out of this, French President Emmanuel Macron, on Bastille Day last Sunday, stood at the front of an open-top car with his nascent European Defence Force behind him, looking for all the world like an updated version of Napoleon. Be in no doubt, 5 years of these people, the European Defence Union will be complete. And what is there for defence can also be used for attack. And you as a House will have no control over it. Vote against this nominee, strike a blow for democracy, strike a blow for your citizens. Do it today.
Thank you, Mr. Farage, says the President.
E adesso
I would like now to give the floor to Ms. von der Leyen, asking her to respond to the comments made by the heads of political groups. Go ahead, madam. Thank you, President. To be quite honest with you, having listened to the last speaker, that provides further proof how important it is that we continue to work closely with our British colleagues in the future. But I think, Mr. Farage, we can probably do without what you've got to say here.